Hey, good morning. I want to warn you right off that these are kind of long problems. We're solving systems with three variables, okay? And I've got the process here that you should take notes on and write down. Number one, we want to choose two equations in which you can easily eliminate a variable. Let's call this new equation after the elimination equation A, okay? So you look at your three equations here, or ever how many equations you have, and you look at two that have probably similar coefficients that you can easily multiply and eliminate one like we did in the last lesson before the quiz. And let's see here, looking at these, I am going to pick the first two. And whenever we solve that elimination, we're going to eliminate one of the three variables. We're going to call that equation A. And then eliminate the same variable from a combination of the equation that you didn't use, so this last one here, and one of the ones you did. Let's call that after you eliminate the variable equation B. Excuse me. So I'm just going to choose the first one and the last one here, and our result from that we're going to call B, okay? Then put equations A and B together and solve that system. You now have two of your variables, okay? Once you've done that, then your last step, substitute your answers from the final step three here, into either original equation to find the remaining variable. Write your solution as parentheses x comma y comma z, close parentheses. Okay. So, like I said, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find the elimination if we take these first two equations. And the reason I'm doing that is if you look here, this one has a coefficient of 1, so I can multiply this easily by 6 here and eliminate the y. And that's what I'm going to do. So my first equation, 2x minus 6y plus 9z equals negative 8. Excuse me, the second equation, 5x plus 1y plus 2z equals 10. Now, like I said, I want to get rid of my y variables here, so I'm going to multiply this second equation by a 6. This is negative 6, so I want this to be positive 6. When I add the two together, my y's will go away and I'll be left with only two variables, okay? So when I do that, if I distribute this one, I will end up with 30x plus 6y plus 2 times 6 is 12. And my 2's look an awful lot like my z's, I apologize. 2z equals 6 times 10 is 60. Okay? So hopefully you're following along. If you've written this down, I'm now going to add the first equation, which was here, and our new transformed equation, this one. So 2x plus 30x gives me 32x. Let me change colors. 32x. Negative 6y and positive 6y cancel each other out. And I'm left with 0y there. I'm not going to write down 0y, though. 9z plus 12z gives me 21z. And negative 8, positive 60 equals, I put a little crossbar there on my z to make it a little clearer, equals 52. Okay? Hopefully everybody followed that. If you didn't, rewind, watch again. You can do this. It just looks hard. It's long, but it's not hard. Okay? So this is going to be my A. Now I'm going to add the first and last equation and eliminate the same variable, my y, here. It's easy to do because this has a coefficient of 1. Okay? So I'm going to rewrite both of those equations. 2x minus 6y plus 9z equals negative 8. And 3x plus 1y minus 8z, these are z's, equal negative 28. I'm going to multiply the second row by 6. When I do that, I have 3 times 6 is 18x. 6 times 1 is 6y. 6 times negative 8 is negative 48z equals 6 times negative 28. Is negative 168. Okay. So, I'm adding the first and last together. This is what I used to have. I've replaced it with this. Okay, and you can rewrite both of those if it's easier for you to do so. So, 2 and 18 give me 20x. And negative 6y and positive 6y cancel out. Positive 9 and negative 48 give me negative 39z. Equals negative 8 and negative 168 is negative 176. Okay, negative 176. Okay, so this, remember, was equation B. Now, our directions here say that we take equation A and equation B, and you put those together and solve that system. So I've got these two equations, and let's see, 32x plus 21z equals 52, and this one over here, 20x minus 39z equals negative 176. going to multiply these two by something that allows me to cancel either the X or the Z. And if you look at those, neither one is a very good choice, honestly. But let's see, 32 and 20 have a difference of 12, and they're both divisible by 2. What can I multiply 32 and 20 both by to get the same value? Let's see. I know they're divisible by 2. So if I did that, that would give me 16 and 10. 16 and 10 have... ...160, of course. So let's see, what would I multiply 32 by to get 160? I would have to multiply that by 5. Okay? So I'm looking for a number here that I can match here. I could have multiplied it by 10 and gotten 320, and multiplied this one by 10, I'm sorry, by 16 and gotten 320. But 10 and 16, I know that the 2 is common there, and I can reduce that. So that's why I'm going ahead and going with a little smaller numbers. I'm going negative 8 here because I want 1 to be positive and 1 negative. Okay, 1 positive, 1 negative. Touched my page too many times. Glad I'm using a pencil now. So, I'm going to do that and get 2 new equations. I'm going to rewrite both of these. Okay, so I'm going to do this, and I'm going to get 2 new equations. So if I multiply 5 times all these values here, I get positive 160x. 5 times 21 is going to give me 105, and that is z's. And 5 times 52 is going to give me 260. And negative 8 times all of these values. When I do that, this is negative 160x. You see where we're going here. And then negative 8 times negative 39. 8972. 83 is 24 plus 7. 312. And these are z's equal negative 8 times negative 176 is a big number. You can use your calculator. It's 1408. Okay. Let me make sure I did that correctly. Yes, 1408. So, I'm going to combine these two, eliminating the X's, okay, negative 160, positive 160, X gives me 0X, 105Z plus 312Z gives me 417Z's. Is equal to 1,668. Let me double check my math. Okay. So, and if I divide 1,668 by the 417 Z's, Z value is equal to 4. Okay? So I've got one of many, the first of many, right? So Now I can take that and plug it back into one of these equations here. So if I do, I had 32x plus 21. Instead of z, I'm going to use 4. 21 times 4 equals 52. 4 times 21 is 84. And I'm going to subtract that 84 from both sides. That leaves me with 32x here equals 52, and negative 84 is negative 32. So x is equal to negative 1. So I've got two of the values. I'm going to go find my third value. Let's see if I plug that up here. My y. And if we look at the y, I'm going to do this equation. It's probably the simplest. 5 times negative 1 plus y plus 2 times positive 4 here equals 10. So negative 5 plus y plus 8 equals 10. Negative 5 and 8 is positive 3. Subtract 3 from both sides, and y is equal to 7. Okay? So I have my x, I have my y, and my z. So our x, y, z coordinate, the solution to all three is negative 1, 7, 4. Okay? So this is x, y, z. 17 minutes. Okay, I'm going to do this next one just a little bit quicker. Hopefully you can follow along. If not, you can slow down the video or just go back and watch again. Let's see, this has a coefficient of 1. Both of these are 3, so this is an obvious choice. I'm going to make this my A. Both of these are even. Okay, so I'm going to add those two and get my B. So let's see here. My A, 4x plus y minus 3z equals 45. 6x minus 4y plus 3z equals 41. I don't have to add or multiply anything because these are opposites, negative 3z and positive 3z. So if I just add those two together, they cancel out. So I have 10x minus 3y equals 86. Here for B, I'll do B in blue. 6x, this one was A, this one's B, minus 4y plus 3z equals 41, and 2x minus 7y minus 11z equals 85. We want to eliminate the z again. It would be easier to eliminate the x, but let's eliminate the z again because we have to have an equation with only two variables. And the same two as this one. So 3 and negative 11, I'm going to multiply this one by 11. And this one by 3. When I do so, the first equation will become 66x minus 44y plus 33z equals 451. Okay, the second equation, distribute the 3. 3 times 2 becomes 6x. 3 times negative 7 is negative 21y. 3 times negative 11 is negative 33z equals, and 3 times 85 is going to be 255. Okay, so I combine these two, 66 and 6, 72x, negative 44, negative 21 is negative 65y. My z's cancel out, one negative, one positive, and 451 and 255 become 706. Now I have A and B. I'm going to combine those two and solve for the third. Okay? So minus 3y equals 86. 72x minus 65y equals 706. I'm going to multiply one of these so that I get rid of either my x or my y. Oh, both of these are even. Let's try that. I could multiply it by 72 and this one by 10, but I hear myself say those and they're both even numbers, so let's try half of that.
I'm just reminding everyone that the flu shot will be given tomorrow between 2:30 and 4:30. There is a paper in the office that you will need to fill out, and you will need a copy at the front and back of your insurance card. You can get that copy to fill out here in the office anytime and have it ready by 2:30 tomorrow. Thank you.
Sorry about that. If I do that and distribute, I end up with 360x minus 108y equals 3096 and negative 360x plus 325. combine those two, I get 217 y's equal. Negative 434. Sorry about that. And I divide by 217. And a public service announcement: if you haven't gotten a flu shot, you should. That with the COVID going around too, it could be very hazardous to your health or your loved ones, your grandparents, small children, etc. People who can't get the shot are at a higher risk. So we have y equals 2. You can plug that back in to one of the equations with just x and y and find x. So if I do that, I had this equation here, for instance, 10 times x minus 3 times negative 2 equals 86. So this negative times negative is positive. So I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides. 10x equals 80. X equals 8. So I've got x and y. I need to find z. So let's use this first equation. 4 times my x of 8 plus y, which is negative 2. Minus 3 times z equals 45. -2 is 30. -3z equals 45. Add 30 to both sides. Sorry, subtract 30 from both sides. And we have negative 3z equals 15. Divide by negative 3. Z equals negative 5. So I have an x, I have a y, and I have z. My x is 8. My y is negative 2, and my z is negative 5. So it's like an ordered pair with 3 values here. 8, negative 2, negative 5 is the solution. I could plug those back in and check. I'm going to show you something. It's been 30 minutes. Let me show you something kind of quicker. Hopefully you have a calculator. If you do not, and I'm assuming most of you that have the calculator are going to have an old one.
Hey, you're good, buddy. Have a good afternoon.
If you have an older one, it may look a little different. Let me do that on here for you with on an older one. And show you something called solving with matrix, solving with a matrix or matrices, if you're saying plural. And let me just use this same equation here. This will not work on a lot of the free calculators that you download as an app on your phone. Yours may be different. You can use the calculator on your laptop. If you have an actual TI-84, of course it will work. Some of the apps will want to charge you extra to get this to work. Now, See, we spent 17 minutes on the first problem and about over 10 minutes on the second one, and that's with me going fairly fast. If I did this on my own, without trying to explain it, I could probably solve it in about 5 minutes. But let me show you how much quicker you could solve it if you used a feature on your calculator. And this is reduced row echelon form for matrix. And you probably want to take notes on how to type this in. It's kind of complicated. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is make sure that all of my equations are in standard form. That's something times x plus something times y plus something times z equals a constant. So when I say plus, I really do mean plus, and where this says minus 3, it's not in standard form. It has to say plus a negative 3. Okay? So anywhere you have a minus, you need to type in a negative 4 for that value. Okay, so let's take a look here. Here's where we're going. Matrix is above the x, inverse of x key here. So you push the second button to get anything in blue. So second matrix, and you end up with all these letters and square brackets there. You'll see three columns, names, math, and edit. We want to edit the first one. The matrix defaults to a 1x1, and the way that works, it's rows and columns. This is three rows, four columns of values. I have an x, y, z, and a constant, that's 4. There's three rows, equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. So I'm going to change this to be 3, enter, 4, enter. And notice that my little table here takes that shape. Now on these old calculators, you have to arrow over to see the last column, but that's fine. I'm going to put in the coefficients of all of these variables. Not the variables themselves, but just their coefficients. If there's one missing, you would type in a 0. Okay, so my first one here is 4. I hit 4, and then I push the enter button. This one is y, so that means it's a 1y as a coefficient. Negative 3, and then my constant's 45. Enter. Okay. 6, enter. Negative 4, enter. 3, enter. 41, enter. 2, enter. Negative 7, enter. Negative 11, enter. 85, enter. Okay? Now, I've got all my values typed in. The next step is I want to save that information. You save it just simply by not typing over it. It's already in there when you hit enter. Okay? So I'm going to move on to something else. So I'll hit second, mode, and notice above mode, the blue word is quit. So I'm just quitting. I'm going to do some math on that matrix. So I go second, matrix. I move over to the column that says math. There's lots of options here. We'll talk about some of these options later, given time. We can do different things with matrices. The one we want is option B. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, A, B, C, D, E. We're looking for B, which is REF. That stands for reduced row echelon form, something you won't learn about until later math, and you don't have to use this method if you're good at solving by elimination. But if you have a big equation, this is the simplest way to solve it. So I hit enter, and then I'm going to tell it which matrix I want to do this math on. So I hit the second matrix button again and tell it which one. We put this one in A. See here it says 3x4, so that's A. And you can just, the one here will bring up A. You can close that out with the parentheses, hit enter, and it will give me a new matrix. This matrix has coefficients with a diagonal here of ones and all the other values zero except for the constants. Now, first thing I want you to notice is see this 8, negative 2, negative 5? And look here at our answer, 8, negative 2, negative 5. So this is the answer. What this rows of values indicate, this is 1x plus 0y plus 0z equals 8. So x equals 8. 0x, 1y. 0z's equals negative 2. So y equals negative 2. Same thing here. 0x, 0y, 1z equals negative 5. So the process that the matrix is doing is reducing all the values so that when we add them together, all the variables are canceled in a row except for 1. And it's left at 1. So it's going through the elimination process that we just did for us until there's only one variable per row. The x row, the y row, and the z row. If your values do not look like this, with diagonal ones there and everything else zeros except the last column, then you don't have a solution. There's a problem. It's either infinite solutions or no solution. And I'll explain more of those later. But I wanted to show you that this is a long lesson. We've done 37 minutes here. I am going to give you guys these three problems. You can use the elimination method, or you can use the matrix to solve those. So write these down. That's the lesson for today. And just turn in those three problems. And I will stop the video.